Sit here, Jane, so I can hear you better.
Jesus Christ, it's freezing outside.
Not really. It's April.
Feels like December.
You young folk need to toughen up a bit.
Isn't that why we're here?
Sort of, I suppose. Sally's running late, so I thought I'd get things organised.
So we see.
This is Jane. She's new today, if we can all make her feel welcome.
Hiya.
I'm sorry, Mandy. Are you in charge now?
Well, someone needs to get things moving till Sally turns up.
And that's you, is it?
I don't mind, honestly. You can do it if you like.
No. I'm fine. You crack on.
Hi, Jane. And Grace.
Hi, Grace.
Angela.
Well, I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to be doing as I'm really filling in for Sally. Where is she anyway? She's never late. Well, why don't we introduce ourselves to Jane and tell her why we're here? Grace, you first.
Okay. I'm Grace. I'm 24. I just got my own place after living in the women's refuge for a while. Still scared to death of being on my own, to be honest.
Do you want to say what happened? Get Jane up to speed?
No. But I will. I was with a guy. A boy, really. We were together from school days. He was nice at first. Everybody liked him, and he was popular at school, good at football and all that. I was kind of a nobody. A girl that nobody noticed, you know? I had a crush on him. All the girls had a crush on him. I couldn't believe my luck when he asked me out.
And what happened?
Well, it was after school. We got engaged way too young. We had no money. We were living together as teenagers, and we started arguing all the time. And bit by bit, he got abusive. He would not let me go out, kept taking my phone off me and going through my messages. He told me that he only went out with me because he felt sorry for me. And then the hitting started.
Sounds like my boyfriend. Well, ex.
It got a lot worse before it got better. That's all I can say right now.
Okay, thanks, Grace. I know it's hard to talk about, but that's why we're here, to support each other. Angela, your turn.
Is it? Oh. Whatever you say, Mandy. I'm Angela. I'm 51. I was happily married until we had kids. Then he started shagging around. He was coming home from work late, staying out overnight sometimes. I knew what was going on. One day I found him shagging Tracy from the meat market. On my new sofa it was.
Sorry, Angela, I thought you always said it was on your marital bed.
What? Bed? Sofa? What's the difference? He's a bastard and they were all dirty slags.
Did you divorce him?
No, we're still together. I love him. We all love them, don't we? That's why we let it carry on. Like the little servants we all are.
Is he still unfaithful?
Yes. He thinks I don't know, but I do. But I have my revenge.
What do you mean? Are you unfaithful too?
I think we're getting a little bit off topic here. Let me tell you some of my history. I'm Mandy, I'm 31, and I was sexually abused by my uncle from the age of 6. It was horrendous, as you can imagine. It went on into my teens until eventually I told my mum and he was arrested, but not charged. They said they didn't have enough evidence. That's the crap judicial system we were up against back then. At least he moved away, so I didn't have to look at him. Thankfully, I think the police are a little bit more clued up nowadays. Jane, do you want to share your story?
A bit similar to Grace, really. I mean, I didn't live with him or anything. He had a flat, so I was there a lot. I'd come home a lot, just covered in bruises. Until one day my mum had it out with me and called the police.
There's a lot more to it than that, but that's the gist of it.
Were you blaming yourself? Thinking, like, if I was a better person, maybe he'd be nice to me.
Yeah, exactly that. It made me hate myself so much. I couldn't bear it.
Like I say, we all need to toughen up a little bit.
That is a really inappropriate comment, Angela. You can't just tell someone to toughen up. It's not that simple. We're a support group. You need to show more compassion than that.
Oh, I am sorry.
Let's move on for now. We can go into more detail in the next session, when Jane feels a little bit more relaxed with us all.
I feel quite relaxed with you already.
Tell you what. Take my number, and we'll talk without so many rude interruptions.
I'll give you a missed call now, yeah?
Grace, your phone's ringing.
Is that your ringtone? You daft beggar.
Well, it doesn't look like Sally's coming today, so if we take a look at the pamphlet and give Jane a heads up on all the support options and legal advice. If you look at the back, you can see the main phone numbers and web addresses, okay?
I'm sorry about last week, Mandy. I just get really upset sometimes.
We all do, Angela. It's totally understandable. Let's just put it behind us. I'm really worried about Sally.
Yeah, I saw it on the local news. Her ex-husband has absconded with her somewhere.
Seems so. Nobody knows where. It's a disgrace. That guy should have been in prison. This is the kind of nonsense we're all up against.
Well, we all have our ways of fighting back.
I suppose so.
Yeah, we're just talking to Brendan about it. It's awful, isn't it?
That's husbands for you?
Yeah, I just hope he's not done her in. I was watching this programme the other day about serial killers. The weirdest bit is that some of them collect belongings of the victims. Like, really morbid stuff. It's horrible.
I'm sure she's okay, Jane. Strong woman is Sally. He just couldn't accept her asking for a divorce, that's all. And we'll be here for her when she gets back. The police will track them down. Is Brendan still here? He said he had to go back into town.
He said he'd leave the keys in the office when he popped out. Where's Grace?
Late again. She really should learn how to drive. The buses are a nightmare.
Well, she definitely said she was coming when I was speaking to her the other night. I'll give her a ring in a bit.
Okay, well, we can get started. How about we talk about how the abuse made us feel at the time compared to how we feel about it now? Angela, your turn.
Your turn? Why do you always say your turn? Why can't you just let people speak when they want to speak? And who made you the boss again anyway? I'll tell you how I feel right now. I feel the same as I did when I first caught my husband shagging Shelley from the meat market in my home. Your turn.
But you said she was called Tracy.
Well, I can't remember everything. They were all whores and what does it matter?
It's funny. I remember every little detail. Like it's tattooed on my brain.
Well, bully for you, Paul Daniels. We're not all magicians.
I'm sorry, Angela. I know the details get blurred. It's an emotional subject. I didn't mean to question your integrity.
I'm sorry too. I don't mean to get angry with anyone. It's just I get really upset dragging all this up again. This support group is the only thing that helps me with the pain.
Oh, please don't cry. How about I make a cup of tea until Grace gets here? Two sugars?
Yes, please.
Jane?
Yes, please. I'm gagging for a cuppa.
I need to listen to some music anyway. That always makes me feel better.
I like your hair like that.
Thanks. You look nice. I like that scarf.
Oh, thank you. Sally gave it to me when I said I liked it.
She sounds lovely.
She was.
Was?
What?
I'm sorry, you just said was. What do you mean?
What I meant was, when she was here, she's not here now.
I'm just gonna ring Grace and see where she is.
Why do you have Grace's phone?
Pedal up, baby, move inside. We'll go dancing tomorrow night.
Jane, you want sugar?
She's still deciding. Your turn.
You put the boom boom into my heart. You send my soul sky high when your loving starts. Jitterbug into my brain. Goes a bang 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 till my feet do the same. But something bugs you, something ain't right. My best friend told me what you did last night. Kept me sleeping in my bed. I was dreaming, but I should have been with you instead. Wake me up before you go, go. Don't leave me hanging on like a yo yo. Wake me up before you go, go. I don't wanna miss it when you hit that high. Wake me up before you go, go. Cause I'm not planning on going solo. Wake me up before you go, go. Night, take me dancing tonight.
How many sugars do you want?
Two, please.